Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Hello students, welcome to Vastech channel. Our second program is to reverse a given string and check whether the string is palindrome or not. So, the program starts from here, dot model small. Let me repeat once again. Dot model is a assembler directive which has got some options like small, tiny, medium, large, compact, huge, etc. Tiny indicates like it has got only one segment in which we are writing both data and code. Small indicates it has got one code segment and one data segment of 64 kilobyte size. Then similarly, medium, one data segment, more than one code segment, and large, more than one data segment and more than one code segment. Next one is dot data. Dot data is a assembler directive. Dot data is assembler directive. Assembler directive means which will direct the assembler regarding the instructions, how to assemble the instruction, how to proceed with the instruction. Dot data indicate the starting of the data segments. Dot code indicate the starting of the code segment. Dot code end with the end. So you can see here, dot code end with the end. See, at the end of this section, you can see end. Okay. So now dot data, data segment starts here. So what is there in the data segment? We have one string. String is represented in normally we represent in quote mark. And name given to the memory location is str1 of type db. Then we will try to find out length. The name given to memory location is len. It is equated with, as I said in the previous program, dollar, that is the ending location of the string minus base address of the string that gives length of the string. In this case, length of the string is 5 characters. String 2, I am going to use string 2 of type db, and length of the string 2 is 50. And I will reserve 50 locations here by using a dup operator, dup. I will reserve 50 locations initialized with the 0. All the locations are initialized with 0. Why I am using 50 locations? The main thing is here. See, this is data segment. In the data segment, our data is stored something like this. You think our data is stored something like this. M, A, D, A, M. First, I want to store the string in the reverse way. That is, first I want to store this one in extra segment. I want to store this one here, M. Next, I want to store A. Next, I want to store D. Next, I want to store A. Next, I want to store M. This is extra segment. Here, we are using two segments. One is extra, one is data segment. In data segment, it is stored something. And reverse of this is stored in extra segment. Then I will check one by one whether this is equal to this. This is equal to this. Suppose M is equal to M, but A is here, some other character is there. S, think like S is there. In the while reversing like M A D A M, instead of A, you think like S is there. You think like that. That is, when the reverse way, it is something like S. Then A is not equal to S. There itself I will stop. I need not to check rest of the characters, and I can say easily it is not palindrome. So I will check one by one. If the single character fails, then only I can say it is not palindrome. So what I have to do? First, I have to store the data in the data segment. Reverse of that, I have to store in extra segment. And I have to check first length is equal or not. If the length is not equal, then I can say it is not palindrome. Second one is if the character is not equal, then I can say it is not palindrome. This condition I have to see. So I use here one more string of I will reserve 50 locations. Name of that is given string 2, and it is duplicate by using duplicate operator. Then I use two messages. The name of the first message location is message 1 and message 2 of type DB string. It is here you can see both end with the dollar. String should be terminated with the dollar. Then next one is code segment. As I told in the previous lecture, that is my previous video, these two statements are initialization of the data segment. In this palindrome program, we want extra segment also. That's why we will initialize the extra segment also in the same way. We'll initialize the extra segment also. So initialization of data segment, initialization of a extra segment. This is done here. So at the rate data means a data segment address is moved to AX. From AX, it is moved to data segment register. Data segment register. Clear? Now, I will move offset address of string 1 to SI, offset address of string 2 to DI. For example, here only I will write. Let me write here only. First one is data segment. I will draw the data segment. This is data segment. And in the data segment, this is M. This is A. M A D A M. This is in data segment. So I reserved extra segment also for to write the reverse of the string. This is reserved, okay, not written it. Now offset address of this one, offset address of this one is moved into SI. Offset address of this one is moved to DI. Now DI contains offset address of this one. That is str 2. This is str 2, right? This is str 1. This location we will call str 1. Offset address of this one is moved to DI. Now length is very easy. We have already found the length. Length I will move into CX. Now what I will do is add SI. Suppose if you think this is 0, offset address is 0, with the length minus 1. What is length in our case? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 minus 1, that is nothing but 4. I will add SI. SI contains 0. 0 plus 4 is equal to 4. Now SI is equal to 4. SI is equal to 4. That means SI is pointing to fourth location. First location, second location, third location, fourth location. SI will point to fourth location here. After that, copy that character to AL. Copy this character to where? AL. We have AX. One is in that AH is there, AL is there. Copy that character to AL. From AL, move that to DI. I will copy from here to here. Here to here, I will move. Clear? I will copy from here to here and here to here. After that, next instruction, I will show you that one. I will decrement SI. Now SI becomes this one, and this side I will increment DI. Earlier DI was here, now DI becomes this one. And I will copy the second instructions. I will increment You got my point. I decrement SI means I want to copy second this one A here. I'll increment DI. I want to store the reverse of this one. So this one. I want to copy this one. In this process, I will check. I will decrement CX register by using loop instruction, CX register each time. And I will check if the CX reaches zero, it will come out. Otherwise, it will repeat the loop. This is the main, see here. I will decrement SI, increment DI, loop up. Once this is done, now you know, let me draw once again. Now you know, see this is a data segment M, A, D, A, M, madam. Okay. Here, this is in the data segment. Extra segment also copied. Extra segment copied in the reverse A. In the extra segment, this is extra segment. Extra segment, this is copied first. M, A, D, A, M. Now, DI is here. Pointer DI is here. Pointer SI, after copying, pointer SI is here. Now, I want to check. To check both my pointer, I want to come back to original position. You know, original position was this one, right? So both pointer, anyway, SI came back to original position. DI is not there in the original position. So what I will do, once again, I will move the offset address of STR1 to SI, offset address of STR2 to DI. And length also I will move into CX because length becomes zero now. And clear direction flag. I will clear the direction flag. So clear direction flag, CLD is the instruction where direction flag becomes zero, direction flag is zero, and set direction flag, STD is the instruction where direction flag becomes one. When direction flag is zero, both SI and DI will be auto incremented after each operation. You need not to use a separate INC SI and INC DI. When direction flag is one, then it will be decremented, auto decremented. You need not to use increment DI. This is the one beautiful advantage of CLD instruction. So CLD instruction I have set it to zero. Then repeat till equal, compare string byte, you compare one byte by one byte till it is equal, repeat till is equal. That means it will compare M with M. Now direction flag is zero, SI will increment, DI will also increment, it will compare A and A. Direction flag is zero, SI will increment, D is incremented, till equal. If anywhere it found not equal, it will come out. Jump not equal, down. Down means second message, display, not palindrome. Otherwise, display first message. As I said in the previous video, move the message 1 offset to DX register and display that by using calling interrupt option in 21H with the 09H terminate. So this is the palindrome program, important program, very simple program. End. Thank you.